Hello everyone, my name is Duncan and welcome back to StoneHearth Alpha 21 and welcome back to the StoneHearth of Cheddar, to the Kingdom of Cheddar. I can't speak today for some reason. I've been having that problem for a while now, so this thing still has to be, you know, removed. I did at the beginning of last episode. As you can see, I finally fixed this. This took me a couple of more hours to do, because it just kept on disappearing and finally I managed to do it somehow. But it's here, it is in. I've got a nice puff here in front of it, and I'm not entirely sure what they are doing with it, but it seems to be fine. The only thing they haven't done yet is placed in the beds and the furniture inside, but I suppose that will be fixed fairly soon. For example, they did place this one here, but they haven't placed, for example, the beds here. So yeah, that's going on. Now, something I would like to address is mainly my loads, my traps area over here. So someone by the name of Nelson said, turn your trapper zones into 10x10 zones and make a lot of them, because the trailer, I suppose it's a trapper, will place at least one in each zone. So I suppose the trapper places one trap in each zone at the least, and if you make them 10x10, that should be fine. So what I want to do is pause the game and install this trapping ground to be gone. Great. Now what we do is we go up here and we start... Let's start here, I think. I think this will be fine. And so what you do is you make 10 by 10. It's a minimum required, apparently. So you do that. And then if they don't work, put 3 space in between. So that's what I'm going to do, because I'm a lazy bum and don't want to do this again. And then you just make a bunch of them, apparently. So apparently this is the way to do it. This is the, you know, pro way of playing StoneHearth. StoneHearth? Hearthstone? I just forgot the name of the game. StoneHearth. There we go. I'm an idiot. So yeah, just keep on doing this and eventually this should be filled up. And so, I think the first cut into this video is going to be fairly early. I've never done that before. I really do hope that 20 trapping zones should be enough, because I have 20 trapping zones here. Now, apparently 10 is the minimum requirement needed, because if you do this, it just doesn't do it, which is fine. So as we go, hello, game. What are you saving? That's fine. So yeah, the saving issue still is not helped yet, but you know, it's not the worst. It just pauses the game for a few moments and then we just, after that, continue the game. So something else that is also interesting to know, maybe, I don't know, is, let's just play this on. I tried to load the save of this game and it just kept on crashing. I tried it 5 times and it just kept on crashing no matter what I did. I switched between the latest version to the normal Alpha 21 version, and I think that is actually the same version, apparently, but I'm not entirely sure about that now. So I'm currently playing on just Alpha 21 because I want to update the game to Alpha 22 or something yet. For, well, reasons mainly. But the game just keeps crashing at loading up the game. So I just tried the latest autosave, and that worked. So I think my save file was corrupted in some way. Now, that aside, I am just doing nothing here. Absolutely nothing. So, what shall we do next? I am actually thinking that looking into the cook's building. So, you know, move these 3 things into a larger building. And I think I can actually place it over here. So what I want to do is I want to go in building and design. And I want to pause the game. And why do I want to pause the game? Because then the game doesn't lag as much. Because the game has to do less. So, we go in here. We go to flooring. And actually, I would like a ash flooring. And I would like it to start there, like 3 in between. So you get something like a 44 by 17 area of ash. It's fine. Now comes the fun part. On this, we want to create this, and there we go. Now, as you may have noticed, I have done something fairly interesting over here. I'm not going to do that, because fuck that shit. I'm just going to build and see what happens. So, I want a couple of things in this building. First of all, I want a reinforced door about in the middle there. And I want a reinforced door about there. That's fine. Then I want to go to windows, and I want to place several windows in here. So, starting here, here, and that does not fit in the middle, unfortunately. But we do have this one for that, if we want to. But do I want to do that now? Don't. I want... I think I'm going to build a giant chimney here. I think that would be cool. Okay, so continuing on. So let's go to the diamond window frames and we just place one there. And one there, and then just every time there's two in between. Why two in between? Because then we can place curtains on them. It's fancy. Actually, let's remove the last one. And we go to this side and we do just exactly the same. You know, the first steps of this build isn't that different from what normally. That's actually why I want to see if I can eventually play the Desert Folk of this game. See how that would be. I have not done that yet, actually. I've only played this race. These people, the forest people. I don't remember the names exactly. I only played them yet. And I really want to try and play something else. Something different. And I think that would be interesting. So, up next, we have this freestanding walls for now. Because what I want to do is go in here. And I want to make a wall from here to about here. And from here to about there. And from there... Oh, hello. Let's not do that. And I think that should be fine. And I want to do the same here. From there to there. And from there to there. Why I'm doing this hopefully will be, you know, clear fairly soon. Up to then, unfortunately, no. And the fairly soon is actually going to be now, when I think of it. Because I want to go in here. I want to go to the crafting tables. And we have these stone ovens. Oh, they are too wide. I thought they were... Oh, well. Okay, place one there. And is there something I have that is three wide? Shit. Yes. So, we can actually... No, we can't play. Damn it! A fucking fine dining table then, I suppose. Because we're fancy like that. Can I place you on there? I can't. Okay, that's fine. Wait, hold your horses. I'll do that. Can I, by any chance... No. Oh, yes, this one works. Oh, no, it doesn't. Damn it! Is there anything that works? A small crate. You know what? I'm just going to place a bunch of small crates here. One, two, three. There we go. So, small crates. Fine. Splendid. We are going to have only one cooker here, unfortunately. What do we? Do we want more cookers? I don't think we actually need more cookers. We're saving, though. That is interesting. Actually, I can place two cookers there now, think of it. So, I want to go in here to the eraser once it's done saving. Please, stop saving. I would like it to be done. Be done. No? Uh-huh. Okay. Oh, should not gonna be. Oh, there we go. Thank ya. Okay, so remove you. And then I want to go in here again and get the cooker. Rotate it apparently the other way around. And one there, and we have two cookers. And of course we need a bit of lightning there. So we go to the wooden wall lanterns, place one there, and we place one there. Great. Okay, let's keep that. I like it. Okay. Now, what else? Actually, we'll place one there. So, what's next? So, what is up next is, of course, the curtains. Because I like the curtains. So, what you do is just simply place a shit ton of them. Just like so, in a row, all to it next to each other. And hopefully, our little heartlings would like it. Almost done, by the way. Just place here, here. Oh, Jesus, a bit more on this side as a result. Okay, there we go. That's fine. Now, I want to make a fur rug and place it here. Place one there. Why? It's like a doormat where you clean your feet before you walk in. Because this is going to be a terrible environment. Or something. And they're not going to be the biggest building, actually. It's not going to be a very big building. But hopefully it's going to be a bit of an interesting building. Because I want to go into this. I want to go to... Ooh. Oh, what can we do, actually? What do you look like? I think I'm gonna keep that. Over there to about there. And from there to there. All the way across to there. And then like so. Right. So shall yes, I'm gonna build this up like so. Just build all the way up. Like so. There we go. Every corner. And this is just a bit of free, but normally when I build, I plan my stuff out. I have not done that today. Today, I just got home. I was tired. I had an 8-hour work day. Well, school day, I should say, because I'm still in college, but we actually are simulating a real-life environment for working now, and that it is fun. It really is a lot of fun, but it tires you out so quickly. And I don't like that as much. So, I'm just sitting here free building. and hopefully doing stuff that look a bit interesting. Now, what can we do? Let's see. The cook sign. What is it? The cook sign? That is the cook sign. Right. I don't want to place that yet now I think of it, but I do want to see if I can... The stone thingamajingies. Place those in these corners. There. And I would like to see if we... Let's get out of this... Oh my god, these big buildings are really making my life a lot harder, aren't they? Okay, let's see. What can we do with this? I'll place one there. And I think actually that will be fine, just doing that. One there and there, and that looks good enough, if you ask me. Now, we have a bit of a blank area here. Is there anything I can place on that? Okay, let's see. What do we have? Jack shit. We honestly don't have anything for it. Oh, we have this for the wall gorgle, but it's not really what I want to add now, do I? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick to these things. And I'm going to see if I can make a... Let's get shutter gray. And is there a middle here? Yes, there is this. And we do this, and we do this, and we do this, and we do this. And... Trying to make a pot. For those curious. More like so then. Oh, hello. There we go. And we do... I don't know, let's fill it up and see what happens. Okay, fine. And let's get a bit of the red and do that like so, and like so. Yeah, no. Hmm. What does the sign look like? Let's get the sign out. Where's the sign? The sign is, I think it is this one. It is the cook sign. Let's hang it over there. Is that a spoon? I think that's a spoon, okay. Let's try and create a spoon. I think that will be a bit more easier than what I'm trying to do here. Okay, freestanding blocks. This one. Shutter gray. Let's see. So we do this, we do this. Actually, we just can just do this and then... Well, that's ugly, isn't it? One more. And we have ourselves a spoon. What does it look like here? Oh, hello. Saving, of course. It's actually too thick, so let's make this too... No. Of course the saving... It literally saves every 5 minutes. I don't know why and don't know how. I wish you could change it to like every 15 minutes or so, not every 5 goddamn minutes. That does look a bit weird. Doesn't it? One... Or okay, let's delete all of that. I said let's delete. Let's delete. There we go. You delete. And we just keep this. I think this will be fine for now. Okay, so now comes the interesting part. I can do two. Can I actually just? No, that's basically tell. That is actually telling me to go fuck myself. It really is. So, what I'm going to do is, same as per usual, I'm just going to go in here and manually build myself a rooftop. But this time I'm actually going to walk you through it like I normally do it. So, you're going to see my pain. The pain every time I have to do this, because bloody hell, this is probably the most annoying part of every build I do. I also realize I should probably not do the roof yet. We should probably go in here and try and add more things in it. Because we're gonna need that. So, I want a few fine dining tables like so. Should be fine. And then I would like... Let's see, what do we have? We have a bunch of stone cauldrons. Let's rotate. Oh, there we go. Let's rotate them and place them here. There we have 3 of those. And then we have the stone mill grinder. And let's place those like... Oh, let's undo that. That's not the place I want to place them. There I want to place them. The other one's fucked up. That explains it. Oh, really? Delete you. Really? There we go. Place you there. Right. So we have 3 stone cauldrons, 2 ovens, and 3 of those things. And I think that would be fine. So what I want to do is I want to go in... let's get a large crate. Rotate it. Put it... There. get another one and rotate it and put it here. Let's put one there. I'm just going to place a couple of, you know, large crates around to see what we can do. You know, to lift up the place a bit. Okay, so we've got that. Let's go in here. Let's get ourselves a couple of wooden lanterns. So one there and one there. One there and one there. We have one there. We have two there. Actually, one on the outside as well. And actually, I think that will do. I think that will do for now. Because I can't really place anything in there now, can I? So, last thing I want to add is go in here and get ourselves a few of these rocks. Rotate them so they look like that. And place them a bit like so. There's not going to be perfect. I already know that much. But there's going to be something. And something as better. Can I actually... I can't. Never mind. The last thing I probably want to add right now, now I think of it, is a bunch of comfy chairs. So, for example, I want one there, and I want one there, and I want... I want one there. Just, I suppose... Really? There we go. Turned around, and we just continue on doing this. Sometimes it's really hard. Okay, so we have something... That looks quite decent, and because I've done this up till now nearly every single building, I want to go in here and get myself a plushy toy rabbit and place it in the corner. I just hide them somewhere. I really like them. I don't know why. So now we've done that, we can actually return to the roof and we can go and continue doing this. Splendid. I like it. What you do then is you remove, take the raise tool and you go... okay, let's see. I'm thinking. I should probably have done this a bit differently. Now I realize I should probably have deleted this and deleted this. And what you do then, you get this one and you just build up like so. Continue on building. But you eventually cut the edge of the peaked roof. And of course, because it's saving, I need to wait again. Which is just great. It really is. Love it. Every moment of it. And I just noticed this is going to be a very low building compared to the rest. Normally I build like 2-3 story buildings or fucking towers. That just reach into oblivion or something. I don't know. And now I'm just building something that's only one floor. Interesting. I think I only want it to be this high. Yes. So what you do then, you've done that, you delete these. One by one. You delete him. Hope that your life is going to be... There we go. That's the first side. Then you go to the other side and you do exactly the same. The only problem is now I don't have the middle roof. So I probably should do something like so. Temporarily. So I know to what point I can go. Apparently to there. So we delete this again because we don't need it. So, really, sometimes this game can be a bit annoying with building, a bit tedious even. And we go in here, delete this side, and we go to this side, and we do exactly the same. Surprising, isn't it? Yes, building roof can be very repetitive. But, do not fret, I am here. Oh, come on, there we go. I'm here, and I have stories, because before I actually got home today, I was in my car just driving home. And here in the Netherlands, we have a shit ton of roundabouts. We really do. I don't know why we have that many. We just apparently do. And I don't know why. No one knows why. It just is a thing we do. Apparently. So we just go in three in between here. And at one of these roundabouts, it was this old lady driving a car. And don't get me wrong, I know nothing about that. Like, you can drive your car if you can. It's fine. But this lady. Honestly. What the fuck? I can tell you that it would have been so I'm making sort of stone. Cool, we're getting stone roof here. So, this lady was driving so incredibly slowly over this roundabout. I should probably... Me just turning off my car, stepping out, putting her car in free, pushing it forwards, out of the roundabout, and then get back to my car and then just drive was probably faster than waiting for her to get through it. It took a long time. So that happened. A little insight in my daily life. I hope you liked it, because I didn't. We've got to do the thing here. Okay. So, oh, no, not there. There. Yeah, that happened. Why is the door broken? What the? Interesting. I'm hearing something. I swear I'm hearing things. I can't be the only one. I know that much. But let's just ignore that for now and hope for the best. Because, quite frankly, if someone is stuck, eventually you get like a notification like, hey! Your people are starving, mate! Do something about it! And then you go in and just teleport them out of there. Because that's how you debug. I'm not gonna tear down that entire building and build it again. No, screw that. I'm not gonna do that. So I just teleport them out of there. Seems like the easier option. I already did that side. Cool. Then we go to this side. And fill this in. Like so. Yep. And I completely fucked it up. Great. Delete all of that. I used the wrong fucking stone. There we go. And we need to use this one. Why this one? Because it's a bit darker. And but not as dark as the rustle rat that I used. Or the edges. Okay. But yeah, normally I tell stories during, you know, relaxing moment. Just to relax and calm down a bit and just talk to you people. Which normally is in games like Transport Fever, actually. But today, we're just gonna have a relaxing all time playing some StoneHearth and building this never-ending roof. Shit. Come on, okay. So, what else do we have to tell? Stories. Yes, so... recently, actually, I honestly don't know if you care about Dungeons & Dragons. I do love the game, I really do. I'm a DM. I've been a DM for 5-6 years now, something like that. I can't quite remember. I've been a DM for a long time now. I've got my own world with a lot of shit in it, with custom lore, custom classes, and everything. And it's just a bunch of fun. It really is. And you can call me a nerd, because honestly, Dungeons & Dragons is one of the most nerdy games you can play. And next to that, I even play Magic the Gathering, so... huh. Anyways, as I was saying, I recently started a Dungeons & Dragons campaign. Actually, now I think of it, I should be playing that about now as I'm recording this, but I'm not. Because I'm recording, and I told them to wait until I was done recording so I can add my video, and then as the video is rendering, I can play some Dungeons & Dragons. That's fine for now. Looks a bit different, but sure, I suppose. It is a bit different. I used the wrong kind here, didn't I? I definitely did. Okay, let's quickly remove that. But yeah, so I started this campaign last Monday, so it is now 2 days ago? Yes, that is now 2 days ago. I can count, promise. And basically the idea for them was to get a ring, or at least go on a quest to find a ring, and then return that to the Emperor of the Human Empire. That was the basic idea of the quest. Now... let's say they didn't entirely keep on... they are doing the quest. Just not in the way I expected. Because one of the characters, the first thing he did was he went to the herbalist and tried to find wheat. Like, dude. Okay. Sure. I suppose. So currently their main objective is to go and find wheat. And their second objective is going to find the ring. Unfortunately for them, they're going to find the ring in the exactly same place as the wheat. At least, that's what I'm going to do, because I am a lazy bum. So, yeah, that's going to be interesting. Next to that, I probably should make mechanics for being high in that game. I wonder how that would be. Like, what bonuses and what buffs it would give? Not entirely sure, and I'm rambling again, aren't I? Of course I am. I'm always rambling in games like this, but that's fine. Really wonder, what would the stats be or the bonuses and debuffs for being high in a game like Dungeons & Dragons? I wanted to make a chimney here, didn't I? Should probably delete all of that, yes. Keep it like so, and that will be fine. Okay, so that's going on currently, that's fine. I should probably go in here and just make this for... now, it's fine, delete this, so. Blend it. And we just continue with this. I'll just continue with what I was doing. But I'm actually really curious about it now. What, like, how to be in Dungeons & Dragons to be stoned. Like, as high as you can possibly be. What debuffs? What buffs? What would happen in combat? Would you be slowed? Would you be... Well, I know for damn sure your reflex is going down. But yeah, that's actually interesting. I should probably look that up. Also, anything else, if anyone's watching this, don't do drugs, really. Just don't. It will save you a lot of money and a lot of problems. Okay. There we go. Light volcano. No, not that. Volcano. Continue on doing this. So what else can I tell? So, yes. I don't know if I actually told it, but I tend to have a lot of nightmares. And most nights I don't remember. I just know that I had a nightmare and then I wake up and I was like, what the bloody hell was I thinking about? So I just cannot remember. But sometimes I have these lucid dreams. I have my last one was, I think, about 1.5-2 years ago, something like that. It's been a while since I had one. But aside, when I have them, I shed my fucking pants. They're really scary. So this one lucid dream is probably the most terrifying I have had of all, because I just could not wake up from it at all. I didn't know anymore when I was sleeping, when I was awake. I didn't know what was real anymore. It was really fucking terrifying. So what happened is, I went to bed at like late in the evening, about an hour, like 2 a.m. or something. That's a normal time for me, but probably late for everyone else in the world. For me, it was like a normal time to go to bed. I was having the day off after it, and I just wanted to play video games. And I went to bed, and for me, I woke up at some point. I woke up and heard something outside. It's fine. I heard it in the living room. So I got up and I tried to go to the living room. When I went to the living room, I know that I couldn't open my door, which was weird because I never have my door locked. Even better, I never have my door closed even. That was a bit terrifying. Then it just got... Can I actually do that? We're saving, of course we are. So that was a bit terrifying as the first one. Then... What happened is, I noticed that I was asleep because I couldn't feel the door handle. It's fine. So I closed my eyes, opened them again, and I was in my bed again. So I was like, okay, fine, I'm awake. And again, I heard this noise, and I still don't know where it came from, which was probably the most terrifying thing of all. I heard something, and I didn't know where it was coming from. Now, let's quickly go and do this. Like so, that's fine, I think. Do this, and you're doing that. Okay, fine. I'll do that, by the way. And let's go from this pillar to that pillar. Right, okay, so I'm gonna make a chimney here, and I think I'll look pretty cool. That does not look great on that one, but we'll have to do with it. So yeah, I was still... Clearly, I was still asleep. I just didn't know that at that point. I wasn't entirely sure. I thought I was awake. So, I tried to get out of my bed. Could not move at all. Fuck. Well, that was shit, I can tell you. Not being able to move. So, I was looking around, trying to figure out what was going on. I just felt this presence close to me. It was terrifying. This presence, it just came closer and closer, closer and closer, until I felt it sit down on my bed. I felt it lay down next to me, and I felt it, like, putting an arm around me. And then, I was able to move my head just a tiny bit, and I just saw this entirely black figure. Like some kind of shadowy form with bright orange eyes just staring at me. I nearly crapped myself. I tried my best to get out of bed. I tried my best to run. I could not move. And as I was panicking, I just, for my woke up again. I was looking around and I saw nothing anymore that could indicate anything terrifying anymore, which was fine for me. Like, I was just done. I was completely done with it. I just wanted to go and play video games again. I had enough sleep for that night. So, of course, I wasn't awake yet. I, on my turn, once again heard something, this time outside. So, I went through my room to the front door. I got to the front door and I got out. And I was standing in my garden, looking around, and I just heard heard voices. Just whispering. Something whispering in the dis in the bushes, like multiple things whispering. So I was like, yo, who's out there? With my, you know, manliness. I went there and like, yo, who's there? Bad idea. What happened is, the voices just stopped. They completely stopped. And there's a black figure, the same one that was in my bed. It just walked around the corner, standing there in its shadowy form, nearly floating above the ground, staring at me again. I ran like hell. I honestly ran like hell, got back inside, tried to get the hell out. But it just didn't work. Now, what is the wall made of again? Just quickly checking. Punga in the background. Okay. Punga in the background. Fine. So I tried to get out of there as quickly as possible. I ran to my room. And as I grabbed the handle of my room again, I just felt something in my shoulder. Something grabbing me. And I didn't live alone. I had a roommate. And I tried to scream out for him, and not a single sound. What the hell? Where the half my room is... Half my roof is gone. Fucking okay. So I have to do that again. That's fine. Anyway, so... I was trying to scream and not a single word, not a single sound, nothing, just silence. I couldn't scream. And as I heard the pull, I just felt the strength in my body just fading. Like I couldn't hold on anymore. I couldn't pull fight back. I just felt them pull me away. And as I let go of the door clink, I woke up again. This is not the end. It just kept on going. It's not my thing. And apparently... Okay. Can I delete that? No. Okay, that's fine. We'll just have to live for that. It's completely fine. So, yeah, that's one of the fun nightmares I had. Oh, that's actually just correct, like so. And basically, I woke up again. Fine. I was sweating like hell. At least I thought I was. I probably was as well, because when I woke up the next time, I was sweating a lot. But it's saving. What happened again? I'm just trying to think. So, first one in bed, then one outside. Oh, yeah. I remember. I heard my stepbrother calling out to me. Yes. My stepbrother, who lives on the other side of the country, I heard calling out to me. In the middle of the night. In my house. So, my first... thought was like, how the fuck did he get in my house? Fine. So, okay. So I got out of bed again. For the millionth time by now. And I just walked up to the living room because that's where I heard him. I was looking around, and I just didn't see him. It was dark. Of course it was. And then, again, in the corner of my eye, I saw something moving. So I turned to it and was like, yo, buddy, knock it out. It's not fun anymore. I want to go back to sleep. And... I looked at it, and then in the darkness, I just saw these two yellow eyes open up again. And that's the moment, basically, when I woke up. Screaming, actually. Like, I legit woke up screaming. I grabbed my phone, just to make sure I was awake this time. I sent a message, like, okay, message has been sent. I got a reply. I'm awake. I hit myself in the face two times. You know, like, really fucking hard to the point that I actually had a... black spot on my cheek, just to be sure I was awake. And that was basically the end of the illusion. I did not sleep anymore that night. I slept that night for, would have been 2 hours maybe? 1.5 hour? Of pure just hell. And it was not fun at all. So that's one of my nightmares. I'm almost done building this thing. So let's go to volcano. Yeah, that's actually the correct one. I was thinking for a moment. Yeah, that is just a random dream I had. I have many, many more dreams. Many, many nightmare dreams. And not all of them were fun. But all of them actually are interesting because my nightmares... This one not specifically. This one was just terrifying on its own. Because, well, fuck demons. Like, I do enjoy the idea of demons. I like to study them. I like to, you know about them. I just don't want them near me. Simple as that. I don't want to screw with them, I don't want to interrupt them, I don't want to provoke them in any possible way. It's possible. Fun time. So, normally what my dreams tend to do, they tend to play in on my biggest fears. Like, I have certain fears. For example, one is that I lose my girlfriend. I honestly do not want that to happen. It's probably one of my biggest fears. Now, let's place this there, and let's place this there, and this there. Put something there, and let's place this one over there. Fine. And so most of my dreams play in on fears I have, and I really, really hate it when that happens. Like, my biggest fear just come to reality. I'm not even talking about spiders. Like, people know that I am absolutely terrified of spiders. Those eight-legged monstrosities, I am actually scared shitless of. So let's just quickly go in here. Let's call this the Cook's Building. Let's build it. Actually, not yet. Let's save it. So you guys can also download it if you want to. Cook's Building. It's fine. Yes, let's build it. Let's start building. Let's play the game for a moment. See, did it work this time? Definitely did. Great. But yeah, my nightmare... What the... I'm not even going to bother anymore. Just if you download it, just change the wall. I don't know what happened there. But... yeah. So, as I said before, my nightmares tend to play in on my biggest fears. One of them being, you know, stuff going on. And oh wow, this actually worked. A lot of traps here. And I think my... Is this my trap? It is. Liam Mayfall, because one of my trappers earlier died. He's just playing traps here and there. So this should be fine. To give me a few more things. But yeah, if you want to know more horror stories or, you know, nightmare stories, things I have seen, things I think I have seen at least, things I have seen in my dreams and so on, let me know, because then during my builds I can actually talk about them, or playing Transport 2 I can talk about them. I probably have more than enough stories for this. But yeah, as this is being built, I am actually going to end this episode, because I've been going on for way too long. So... thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, do whatever you want, and I'll see you next time. Bye!